What if I told you there's a secret to getting consistent AI characters through prompting only? I've spent weeks testing every single method out there, every setting, every trick, every tool. And after all that trial and error, I finally discovered a workflow that actually works. What I'm about to share with you completely transformed how I approach AI character creation. Think about it. If you've ever tried making AI-generated characters, you know the biggest problem: inconsistency. One moment, your character looks perfect. The next, their entire face changes. Their hair is different. Their expressions shift. The AI just doesn't seem to remember them. Look at these images on my screen. Same character, different angles, different poses. This isn't just a random trick. It's a structured method. So today, I'm going to show you how to generate AI characters that stay identical across multiple images. Same face, same outfit, same overall look, no matter the background or scene. And the best part? You don't need expensive software or complicated AI models. This method is completely free. In this video, we'll generate multiple images with consistent characters, and then we'll bring them to life using an image-to-video model. Let's dive in. Step 1. The foundation of character consistency. The biggest mistake most people make is not defining their character well enough before generating images. AI doesn't remember faces the way humans do. If you don't give it specific and consistent details, it will fill in the gaps randomly, leading to slightly different results every time. So the first step is to build a strong profile. Before generating anything, open ChatGPT and type, "I want to create consistent characters with AI. Please generate me a full prompt for my new AI character, Jexy. She is a 30-year-old stunning curly hair girl with brown eyes. Generate her in a standard pose." ChatGPT has crafted a powerful prompt for generating consistent AI character. The more specific you are when describing your character, the better the results. Because when details are missing, it fills in the gaps on its own. So be clear, be detailed, and give ChatGPT everything it needs to bring your character to life exactly how you imagine it. Let's say, for example, you want to create a futuristic detective character. Instead of just saying, "a cyberpunk detective with a long coat and glowing blue eyes," a better prompt would be, "a cyberpunk detective named Jack with sharp angular facial features, short black hair slicked back, glowing blue cybernetic eyes, and a signature long trench coat embedded with neon circuitry. He has a calm but intense expression, a subtle scar over his left eyebrow, and wears a tactical utility belt with futuristic gadgets." The more specific you are, the more recognizable and consistent your character will be across different images. Once you have your character's full description, copy it and move to the next step. Step 2, generating the character correctly. Now that we have the prompt, it's time to generate the character in an AI image tool. For this method, we'll use Google ImageFX, which is completely free and doesn't require advanced technical knowledge. But wait, before you say ImageFX isn't available for everyone, I've got a solution for that too. As you can see, when I am connected to my normal IP address, ImageFX is not working. But no worries, you can easily bypass this restriction with a VPN. Personally, I'm using FastVPN, and it is working wonders for me. Let me show you. Simply open your VPN application and select a country where ImageFX is available. Currently, it is available in the United States, New Zealand, and Australia. I will choose US and click Connect. That's it. You're now ready to log in and start using ImageFX just like any other AI tool. Just check the link in the description to get your first month of FastVPN for less than $1 and unlock full access instantly. Now paste the prompt that we generated earlier into the text box, but before hitting Create, we need to tweak a few settings to improve consistency. Here's what to adjust. First, style presets. Choose one or more and stick with it for every future image. If you mix different styles when generating different images, your character will look inconsistent. Second, high contrast and realistic lighting. This keeps the image from looking too generic and helps lock in the details. And third, high detail mode. More details mean fewer changes across images. Now, hit Create, and there's your character. Take time with this step, because you have to do this only once. We will use this created character through different environments, but we're not done yet. Step 3, the secret to keeping the same face. Most people think they've finished once they generate the first image. But if you generate a second image, even with the exact same prompt, you might notice that the face still changes slightly. This happens because artificial intelligence doesn't actually remember faces. It generates them from scratch each time. So here's the trick: locking the seed number. In the ImageFX interface, you can see this small lock button. Just click on it to lock the seed number. This ensures that every future image is generated from the same base structure. Without this, even small variations in the AI's randomness will cause the character's face to shift over time. Let's test it. With the seed number locked, generate a second image. The face is identical. Same features, same structure. Now you have a character that won't change between images. Step 4, testing the character in different scenes. Now that we have a locked character, let's take things a step further. Can we put Jexy into completely different environments without messing up her appearance? To test this, let's use a dramatic example. I'll ask ChatGPT, I want you to describe me a scene where Jexy, the character that you generated me in the last prompt, is walking through ancient pyramids. It gives me a description. Now I copy it and paste it into Google ImageFX, but I keep Jexy's original character prompt intact. This is important. Never remove the original character description. We're just adding new details about the environment and situation. Now, I hit create, and there she is. Same face, same features, just in a new setting. Let's try another one. Jexy standing in the forest holding a coconut. Again, I paste this on top of the original character prompt and keep the seed locked. Hit create, and it works again. The AI perfectly maintains her identity. Step 5. Creating a full story. Now that we know how to keep AI characters consistent, we can go even further, turning them into fully illustrated stories. Let's say I want to create a short story about Jexy as a young and promising singer. I ask ChatGPT, I want you to write me a short story about Jexy, a young and promising professional singer. It generates a great story, but instead of creating just one image, we break it down into key moments. I then ask, I want you to identify the key visual scenes in this story that would make great illustrations. Now, I have a list of moments. For each one, I combine the scene description with Jexy's original prompt and lock the seed. I generate each image separately, ensuring her look remains the same throughout the entire sequence. By the end, I have a fully illustrated AI-powered story with a consistent main character. Step 6, animating images with Leonardo AI. Now that we have a fully illustrated AI-powered story, it's time to bring it to life through animation. Static images are great, but with a bit of animation, they become engaging video content. To do this, we'll use Leonardo AI because of its new update. Here's how. Go to leonardo.ai and log in with your Google account. I want to show you a new feature that I've been testing with Leonardo AI. They recently updated their website with a new image-to-video model, and now the motion is much better than before. I think they're using the WAN 2.1 model for motion generation. Here's a screenshot I took right when the update rolled out. The model was listed as WAN 2.1 at the time, but now it's simply called Motion 2.0. Either way, it's the same powerful update. They've just renamed it. Each animation costs 250 credits, so it's not cheap. But you get a fully animated videos from images without any watermarks. I'm using the paid version of Leonardo AI, but if you want to create animations completely for free, you can check out the WAN.video website. You get free credits every day that you can use to generate motion from your images, but it adds a watermark to every video. Now, head back to ChatGPT and ask it to give you an animation prompt for all the key scenes it generated for you. Just copy the prompt for the first scene and go back to Leonardo AI. Once you're on the home screen, click on the video tab, select the image icon, and upload your starting frame. Then, simply paste the prompt that ChatGPT gave you and hit generate. Repeat this step for every image you've created. And by the end, you'll have a fully animated story, made with actual video clips, not just still images. Now it's your turn. Try it out. Generate your own character, drop them into different scenes, and see how well this method works for you. If this video helped you out, make sure to hit that subscribe button. There's so much more epic content coming your way. Also, I've noticed people watching from all over the world, so leave a comment and let me know where you're tuning in from. I'd really love to know. And if you're excited to learn how to create cinematic, movie-like content using just AI, make sure to check out this next video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.